that's bullshit.
I just think Nine are just bullshit artists.
Mm. Okay.
Thanks, mate.
Thanks, Don. All right. 27 after midnight, 131873.
You're not allowed to bullshit, Nick. You have to...
But I'm used to bullshitting. That's my job.
No.
Someone says I'm the joke. It's not the oldest profession in the world. The story goes in quick terms that there was a doctor, there was a businessman, and there was a politician sitting around having a drink after dinner. And the doctor says, "I'm very proud. I'm a member of the oldest profession in the world." And the others say, "Oh, come on, how do you work that out?" And he says, "Well, I know my Old Testament. You go back in the book of Genesis. Out of Adam's rib, Eve was created. That's surgery. I'm a doctor. I belong to the oldest profession in the world." So they have another snort, and the second bloke, the manager, says, "You know, that's not right, because you go even further back in the book of Genesis, and it says that out of chaos, order was created. That's what I try and do every day in my business. That's management. So I'm the part of the oldest profession in the world." And, of course, it doesn't take the politician another snort before he chimes in and says, "Oh, yes, but who do you think created the chaos in the first place?" Yeah.
Have a look here. Don, hello.
Yes, good morning, Jim.
Yes, Don.
Agree with Stephanie, 100%. She's a good lady. Just a bit of a gag on the run. Whales that make it to the far south coast of the state may be called New South Wales. You like that one?
What was that again?
Whales that make it into the far south.
Oh, right, New South Wales. Yeah, sorry. Boom, boom.
Boom, boom. Senator Coonan and Senator Conroy had a debate in regards to communications. Senator Coonan creamed her opponent.
I believe so.
Absolutely. You know, and exposed Rudd and Co. to more, you know, policy loss, you know. I might YouTube that bit later on, to edit that.
And the education debate the other day, who was that between? Stephen Smith, I think.
And Julie Bishop.
And Julie Bishop, and yeah. She just totally trounced him.
They're being exposed. They're just clawing their way to the 24th with no real policies. And, I mean, it's a sham election. And Stephanie is right, and Barry Cassidy is right, that the media haven't... ask the tough questions, and I've been very frustrated for the last few weeks. Sitting up my telly, you know, ask him this, ask him that. You know, they've got no gumption.
I've got the story here. out of the Australian on Saturday, veteran political journalist Barry Cassidy has urged the media to declare war on Kevin Rudd, warning the opposition leader is avoiding scrutiny by fighting his campaign on FM radio. After 34 days of campaigning, Mr. Rudd is yet to appear, and it's too late now, on the ABC Sunday morning political program Insiders, prompting the program's host to ask whether he is dodging the tough questions. To refuse to go on Insiders fits a pattern. There are only two programs that focus exclusively on politics, Insiders and Meet the Press. He hasn't done either in this campaign, and he's not going to, Cassidy said on Friday. But he will be doing lots of FM radio, one senior journalist said. Cassidy, former press secretary to Bob Hawke, when he was a Labor Prime Minister, said he did not believe Mr. Rudd's reluctance to appear was based on the program or personalities. The strategy is to avoid as many as possible of the longer considered interviews that he can. Compare that to John Howard. This was Barry Cassidy saying, compare that to John Howard and John Howard's approach. He will always do those interviews, the longer considered interviews. Perhaps it is a sign of his maturity and Kevin Rudd's lack of experience.
Absolutely, and I think those are pretty golden words coming from a fellow like Barry Cassidy.
That's from his, why I thought they were worth putting out there this morning.
As for the IPCC, Jim,
now that's scaremongering.
Yeah, well, I wonder how many of those signatories to that report actually wanted to be signatories after watching the Great Global Warming Swindle. I've downloaded that, and I've downloaded An Inconvenient Truth. I think Al Gore wanted people to pay for that, but I got a nice copy from the net, as well as the other one, Great Global Warming Swindle.
Have you looked at Bob Carter's YouTube presentation on my website?
I'm going to have a look at that later on.
It's a couple down from the top. I think it's the second one from the top.
I'll have a Captain Cook of that, Jim.
All right. I've got to go.
Catch you, mate.
Thank you. It's just on 3 to 5. Speaking of scaremongering, I did mention it earlier, that Ashfield Council, they are putting markers showing where the water could end up, given worst-case scenario. If the seas rose by 2 metres, up to 300 homes in the area could be underwater. Now, even the IPCC says, well, they were saying 59 centimetres. Yesterday, I read 43 centimetres. Now, and I don't know if that was a typo, but Ashfield Council, scaremongering, they're putting markers up to show where the water would be if it went up 2 metres. Why stop there? Why not go 100 metres or 10 metres?
When I resigned from the IPCC, I thought that was the end of it. But when I saw the final draft, my name was still there, so I asked for it to be removed. Well, they told me that I had contributed, so it would remain there. So I said, no, I haven't contributed, because they haven't listened to anything I've said. So in the end, it was quite a battle. But finally, I threatened legal action against them, and they removed my name. And I think this happens a great deal. Those people who are specialists but don't agree with the polemic and resign, and there have been a number that I know of, they are simply put on the author list and become part of this 2,500 of the world's top scientists.
Research relating to man-made global warming is now one of the best-funded areas of science. The US government alone spends more than $4 billion a year. According to NASA climatologist Roy Spencer, scientists who speak out against man-made global warming have a lot to lose.